Now the formation of the extraembryonic mesoderm or the primary mesoderm. It also occurs in the second week of the development. Now this diagram, in this diagram, it is the amniotic cavity AC, while this is the primary yolk sac. Primary yolk sac, or it is the exocoelomic cavity. Exocoelomic cavity, and this is the embryonic disc. Means this is the embryo. Now this embryo, we have discussed, it has the two layer, epiblast directed above towards the amniotic cavity, or we can say it forms the dorsal axis, while the hypoblast, that is, forms the roof of this primary yolk sac. And the this surrounded by the trophoblast cells. In the trophoblast, this purple, it is the syncytio, and this is the cytotrophoblast. Now, with further development, there is a formation of the extra embryonic mesoderm. This extra embryonic mesoderm is mainly formed by the cells of the yolk sac. Cells of the yolk sac, these cells, the cells that are the Hughes membrane, exocoelomic membrane, they proliferate and form mass of cells. This mass of cells is present between amniotic cavity and the, this is the yolk sac, and this, it is the cytotrophoblast, and outermost, it is the syncytotrophoblast. Now, this mass of cells, in this diagram, both layers are close to each other. Close to each other. Now, there is a separation. Separation of the trophoblast from this amniogenic cavity and this primary yolk sac. By the mass of cells, this mass of cells is known as the extra embryonic mesoderm, or it is known as the primary mesoderm. The question is, which cell form this extra embryonic mesoderm? It is the cells of the yolk sac that form the extra embryonic mesoderm, along with a small contribution from this cytotrophoblast. This is the cytotrophoblast, and outermost is the syncytium. So, this extra embryonic mesoderm is formed by the yolk sac cells as well as the cytotrophoblast cells. Now, this extra embryonic mesoderm separates the trophoblast from this cavity. Why it is known as the extra embryonic mesoderm? Because it is present. Where is the embryo? This is the embryo. It is the embryonic disc. This mesoderm is situated outside the embryonic disc. So it is known as the extra embryonic. And it does not participate in the formation of any tissue of the embryo. It has no role. It is an important point. The extra embryonic mesoderm has no role in the formation of any tissue in the embryo proper, and it is first synthesized, it is known as the primary. So that is how the extra embryonic mesoderm is formed, and it separates the trophoblast from the yolk sac cavity and the amniotic cavity. Now with further changing, there is a small cavity, space appears. These are the small cavities. Appears in this extra embryonic mesoderm. These are the small cavities. and these cavities ultimately fuse to form a large horseshoe cavity. And this cavity is known as the extra-embryonic cavity. Now this is the third cavity formed. Or it is the chorionic cavity. It is the chorionic cavity. We see in this diagram, this cavity is present whole of the extra-embryonic mesoderm, except this part. This part, it is the extra-embryonic mesoderm, where there is no cavity is present. And this part connects this amniotic cavity with this trophoblast. Cavity is completely present except this region, and this region connects this amniotic cavity with the trophoblast, and this region is known as the connecting stalk. Connecting stalks, because it connects this amniotic cavity, these structures along with the trophoblast, and in future this connecting stalks, it forms the umbilical cord. Umbilical cord. So this is the importance of the connecting stalks. What is the connecting stalks? It is basically the extra embryonic mesoderm, which is not splitted, divided by this chorionic cavity. And in future, this connecting stalks becomes this umbilical cord. Now, with the formation of this cavity, the extra-embryonic mesoderm is divided into the two layers. One layer, this is the first layer, the layer which is present deep to the trophoblast, and continuous with this amniotic cavity region. And the second layer that lines the yolk sac. This layer, this is the second layer. And this is the first layer. These two layers are the parts of the extra embryonic mesoderm. The layers which is present deep to the trophoblast, it is known as the somatopleuric layer of the extra embryonic mesoderm. It is the somatopleuric layer that lines the inner surface of the trophoblast, while the layer that lines outer surface of this yolk sac cavity, it is the splenomegaly layer of the extra embryonic mesoderm. So, with the formation of this cavity, chorionic cavity, this extra embryonic mesoderm divides into the somatopleuric and the splenomegaly layer of extra embryonic mesoderm. Now you see, this embryonic disc, it is the epiblast and the hypoblast, along with this amniotic cavity and this yolk sac suspended into this cavity. This cavity is the chorionic cavity, extra embryonic cavity or chorionic cavity, by this connecting stalk. Now, so now we change, see the changes from this to this, how the chorionic cavity is formed. Now there is a formation of the membrane, extra embryonic membrane. The first layer, it is the chorion. This layer is the chorion. This chorion, it is formed by the trophoblast, both layer, It is the syncytiotrophoblast and the cytotrophoblast. And it is the somatopleuric layer of the extra-embryonic mesoderm. These three layers combine and form the important extra-embryonic membrane that is known as the chorion. Then it is the amnion. Amnion, this is the amniotic cavity and its root. This is the amnion. Amnion, it is the amniogenic cells derived from the epiplast. This amniogenic cells derived from this epiplast surrounds this amniotic cavity, and this layer is the amnion. With further development, we see this amniotic cavity will increase large in size and enclose, cover the whole uterine cavity. So there are two layers. It is the chorion. What is chorion? It is the trophoblast plus somatopleuric extra-embryonic mesoderm. What is amnion? It is the amniogenic cells derived from this epiplast cells. And the embryo is still in the bilaminar embryonic disc, covered by the two cavity, amniotic cavity and the yolk sac. Now, further point, as this cavity, chorionic cavity, is formed and the embryonic disc increases in the size, this primary yolk sac becomes smaller, and this is now the secondary yolk sac. This primary yolk sac becomes the secondary yolk sac. This yolk sac, remember the class of the gametogenesis. It is the primordial germ cells first visible in the wall of this primary yolk sac. And the second importance of this yolk sac, it provides nutrition to this embryonic disc. So it is the importance of this yolk sac.